Dennison, and when I'm not hunting for wilder people, the wilder chicks are hunting for me because I'm skunks. But there's more to me than skunks. Welcome to my world.
It's not really it's not a funny moment, but it's an embarrassing moment. So there's a scene where I first get this dog in the film, and I got to bend down to give it a hug. And in one of the shoots, as you can see, I cut the cheese. So I went to go bend down, and I had to go taller, and I let out some loose air. And then I got up, and I'm like, sorry. And then they all said, oh, we thought it was the dog. And I was like, stink. Tēnā koutou katoa, ko maunga tautari te maunga, ko tōpe hai hai te awa, ko waikato te rohe, ko roku moana te marae, ko Julian taku ingoa, te kaumātoru aku tau, nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Ricky Baker.
He is a baddie, a youth court regular.
We're hoping that this change of scene will help straighten him out.
You hungry? That's a silly question, isn't it? Look at you.
So my role, I play a character called Ricky Baker. He's a foster kid. He's been moved home from home. He doesn't really like talking to people. He's really closed. He's really like, you know, keep it to himself. It was, you know, definitely on set was quite hard, you know, evolving and getting into the character of Ricky Baker. But Taika and especially Rachel House and Sam really helped me get into the character. You know, Sam Neill, who was in Jurassic Park, Piano, Sleeping Dogs, a whole lot of movies, really famous. While he worked with this guy. This guy, yep, this guy. I know, you're looking at me like, why would he work with that guy? But he worked with this guy.
Ricky, this is Heck. You can call him uncle if you like.
No, I can't.
Bella told me to tell you that you should give me something to do. Is there anything you want me to do?
Yeah. Leave me alone.
Cool.
Don't you worry about it.
It's a lot different, you know, walking down the street, you get a lot more. Is that Ricky Baker or that's that boy off the movie? Like, you can, and you can see people, like, people be pulling out their phones, getting ready to take selfies and stuff. So it's a lot different. Well, there's like the science thing called gravity, and it like holds you to the ground, so you know, you ain't gonna float off. No, but definitely my family, they keep me grounded, you know, knowing that, you know, no matter how big your head gets, it's not gonna get as big as the aunties. No, I'm just kidding, I'm just joking, mom. I'm sorry. So they always keep you grounded, definitely the family and my brothers and sisters. I'll be like, man, I'm famous as, and they'll be like, not until you get $1 million, you ain't famous, and not until you pay for this, you ain't famous to me, mate.
It has been interesting to see my most shy baby evolve into someone who is comfortable
not baby,
in a number
child.
Of ways.
Child.
He'll be my baby at 60. Myself and my husband, I think the thing we're most proud of is what hasn't changed.
What's fresh about me? Oh yeah, I'm a twin. No, we're brothers, we're twins. Yeah, I said my name's Julian Dennison, and he's Christian Dennison, if you don't pay.
Don't you agree?
Cut that out.
Yeah.
Every time me and my mates see each other at school, we walk up to each other like I have some pretty white friends. But I walk up to them and they'll be like, oh, sup, bro? And I'll be like, oh, got up. And then we'll give each other a hoggy in the middle of class. So I don't know if that's fresh enough. I do like jandals. They're really comfortable. My mum wore jandals in Berlin when it was about -5, I think. Our luggage was not at the airport when we got there, it was on the later flight. So I only had board shorts because I was from New Zealand. My legs don't get cold. I'm like Iron Man, you know, solid, titanium. I was walking around minus five, Mum was in her jandals, and all of these tourists get off the bus. And they're like, he's gonna get hypothermia. He's gonna die. So, yeah, I can wear shorts anywhere and my legs won't get cold.